Hi there. In this video, we'll show you how easy it is to set up a Microsoft SQL Server Database API in Dream Factory. Before you begin this task, make sure you have the credentials to your SQL Server database. This is the Dream Factory admin dashboard. To start building your API, navigate to the API Generation and Connection option and select the Database dropdown. Here, you'll find your created APIs, and to create a new one, press the purple plus button. Here you'll see all of the different database connectors Dream Factory offers. For this demonstration, we'll navigate to the SQL Server connector. Here we'll be prompted to provide various details around this connection, starting with giving our API a name and description. For this demonstration, I named it SQL Server API. Then we'll click Next to continue the configuration. Here we'll have to provide the credentials to access this database. Once all of the required fields are filled out, we can go to the bottom and click Save. At the bottom, we can see confirmation that the API has been saved. Next, let's navigate to the API Docs tab, then select the SQL Server API we just made. Here you'll find the standard open API spec docs. Dream Factory automatically projects your full CRUD capabilities against your database, including access to your schema, your tables and views, as well as any stored functions or procedures. If we click on one of the GET commands, we can set parameters and see your database's schema. However, if I want to invoke this API outside of Dream Factory, I must provide an API key because Dream Factory has no concept of a public or open API. Let's head over to our menu. Select Role-Based Access and press plus to add a new connection. Here, we'll provide the corresponding information. First, by providing a name, then by selecting the service and granting read-only access to the SQL Server API we just created. Then we'll press Save and move on to the final step. In order to create an API key, head over to the API Keys dropdown. We will create a new key by selecting the plus button and providing our details for the API key. Now that I have named my API key and attached the read-only role to it, I can hit Save and we will now have our API key available to us. Since we now have our API key, we are able to leverage our newly created SQL Server API outside of the Dream Factory platform by utilizing the request URL in tandem with the API key passed securely to the headers of the request. And that's it. In less than 5 minutes, we created a fully documented, secure REST API for SQL Server. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Have any questions? Reach out to info@dreamfactory.com or visit www.dreamfactory.com for more resources.